Hi everyone, in this video we will create our RecyclerView adapter. So for our adapter we will create a new class. So inside my UI package I am creating a new Kotlin file class and I will name this class as Home RecyclerView Adapter. Now as it is a RecyclerView adapter, we need to extend RecyclerView.adapter. And for adapter, we need to define the type of our viewholder class that we have created here using a sealed class. So we will use this class as our viewholder type, like this. Now we need to implement some member functions. So what you can do is you can press Option Enter in case of MacBook, and for Windows you can press Alt Enter, or you can also click on this bulb icon. And now I will select implement members and I will implement the three member functions that are required. The first one is on create view holder, and this will create the view holder for our recycler view item. The next one is the on bind view holder, and inside this function we will bind the data to our view holder. And finally we have get item count that will tell the item count for our recycler view. So from this function we need to return the size of our recycler view or size of our list. So first I will define a list that we need to display or that we want to display in our recycler view. And we already created this class that is our home recycler view item. So we will use this class for our list. So here I will define where items equals to list of, and the type is home recycler view item, like this. Now I will create a setter here. So whenever we will set items to our recycler view, we will update the recycler view using this function, that is notify dataset changed. And here we will write field equals to value, that means we are setting the value that is passed for the setter. Now we have items here, and to this function we can simply return the size of the items. So here we will write items.size. Now we need to create view holder and we need to bind data to the view holder that is created. But before creating the view holder, we need to check what type of view holder we want to create, as we have three different types of view holder for our recycler view. So here we can override one more function that will tell us the type of the current view. So we have override fun get item view type. Now to this function, we get the position. And with the help of this position, we can get what is the type of current item. And based on that, we can create the view holder here inside this function. So what we will do here is we will write return when items position, like this. And here we can add remaining branches because we have used sealed class. And the compiler knows what are the possibilities for this when statement. So here I can simply select this add remaining branches option, and the ID will do rest of the things. So we have all the available conditions for this when here. Now we need to return an integer from this function. So what I will do is I will return the ID for our items. So for director we have r.layout.item. And we need to import the R class. So we have item director. The same way we will return item movie and item title. Now here before creating the view holder, we can write when view type. And here we have three cases. The first one is r.layout.itemTitle. The next one is r.layout.itemMovie, and finally we have director. We will also add an else. So if we have any other situation, we will throw an exception. So for now, I am using illegal argument exception. And I will write the message as invalid view type provided. Now for all these three cases, we need to create view holder instance accordingly. So for item title, we will use this title view holder. And for item movie, we will use movie view holder. And for director, we will use this class. Now for this case, that is our item title, we will return an instance of title view holder. So here we can write, I will delete the curly braces because I don't need it. I will write here home recycler view holder and then title view holder. Now to the constructor of this title view holder, we need to pass item title binding. And we can inflate it using the function that is item title binding dot inflate. Now to this inflate function, we need to provide a layout inflator instance, and we can get the instance using layout inflator class. So we will write here layout inflator dot from, and for the first parameter, we will pass context. And to get the context, we can use the parent view group. So here I will write parent.context. For the next parameter, we have the parent itself. And for the last parameter, we will pass false because we do not want to attach it to parent. So we will pass false. Now the same way, I will return view holder for item movie. So here I will write home recycler view holder dot movie view holder. And for the binding, this time I will use item movie binding like this. And we will do the same thing for director. So we will use home recycler view holder dot director view holder. And we will use item director binding dot inflate. And we will pass the same parameters. Now we have our onCreate view holder ready. And this will create the view holder based on the current item. And we have three different types of view holder for this recycler view adapter. Now finally, we will bind the data inside this onBind view holder function. So here we will check when holder. And because we have a sealed class for this home recycler view holder, the IDE will generate all the cases. So here we will select add remaining branches, and we have all the available branches. Now what we will do here is we will call the bind function and we will pass the item that we need to bind. So here we will write holder dot bind and we will pass items position. And we also need to cast it as home recycler view item dot director. And the same way, we will bind other items to the view holders. So we have movie for this, and we have title for this case. That's it. Now we have binded all the values with view holders. And that's it for our adapter class. Now we need to fetch the items from the API and we need to use this adapter to display our recycler view. And that we will do in the next video. So thanks for watching everyone. This is Bilal Khan now signing off.